this is overall my skin. This is how we look in. This is how we come in. Okay. So, welcome to my channel. If you decide you want to stay and be part of the Kin Club, subscribe down below and hit me up on all my social medias if you have any questions or need to know anything. I got you. So today I'm actually recording my skincare routine. This is about my third skincare routine on my channel, but each time I'm always either adding stuff or I change things or I've learned more things. I'm really big about skincare, like okay, don't play. And so I just like every time I learn something, I want to share it with you guys, and I wait for a while. These products I've been using since last summer till now. I hope you guys learned something, and let me know if you tried down below or any of the products alone. Let me know what you think. Also, I have my AirPods in. Hopefully this is making it sound better because the vent's literally right above me, so I didn't want that to like block you from hearing me. But yeah, it's like, it's only 1:54 in the morning that I'm recording this right now. I should definitely be sleeping. Okay, so basically pretty much using the same products as I did before, but I did add a few products to my skincare routine to help me a little bit. And then I wanted to go over a little bit. I talked a lot in the past before really big on like making sure you're always like washing your face. So I always try to take care of my skin as much as I can just to make sure that it gives me at least a piece of armor, you know, to feel good about. So today, for instance, I just did like my eyebrows, mascara, and I had like a MAC Neural Skin Finish powder, so I thought today was a good day to do it. A lot of my makeup is probably off because I have been sleeping throughout the day. It's like I said, it's 1:57 in the morning at this point, so I've been like sleep, taking some naps. I'm gonna go through and show you how to take my makeup off, the cleanser that I use, my toners, my serums, what I use for pimples, just the whole nine yards. And okay, so take my glasses off. Expose me. Alright, so first off, what I'm going to use, and you can use any makeup remover, it's not anything in particular, but this is the one that I use. I like it a lot. It's like kind of the travel size, so I take it with me like everywhere. I just put it on the cotton round, and then I'm just gonna go like this and wipe my face. And I try not to rub too much. You don't want it to be like harsh on your face. You just kind of want to let it do the work. Look at that. My new skin finish is how I catfish people. Didn't you say that? Okay, so now that I've done that, I removed all my makeup off my face. I'm exposed. I'm kidding, I'm still fine without makeup, so I'm not even tripping. Like, you can see me like this all the time. If you watch my vlogs, I'm always like this. Anyways, so the first thing that I'm going to use is my cleanser. The cleanser that I use is the First Aid Beauty Pure Skin Face Cleanser. Using this product, you can definitely sleep. I just pour some on my hand. It's really good. I like it. And then I just rinse some water. And then, you know, is the water within? Sure. I have like this a lot more like that. And then I do have a spin brush, but I don't even use it anymore, so. And then you're just gonna like wave it off your face a little bit. You don't want to, like I said, you don't want to pull it be too hard. So now also a big step too is if you do wear glasses like I do, make sure you clean your glasses because the leftover makeup on your glasses can also help you like break it out. So always clean your glasses. You get them to go off your glasses, sis or sir. So the next step after your cleanser is going to be a toner. You, like, obviously you can use any products that you want, but I will say these First Aid Beauty products, these products that I'm using right now, have my skin literally glowing this time last year. And like since I started using again, my face is starting to glow again. I noticed I ran out of all the products probably about last summer, and I noticed my skin was not the same after that, and literally went back and bought these products at Sephora. Skin's back glowing again. Skin's back popping. and my skin was all, had always been healthy and good, but it was not glowing. There's a difference. So my next step is actually going to be toner. I do use a Versace Beauty toner. I do like that one. It's an exfoliator and a toner in it, and I don't exfoliate my skin because I have sensitive skin, just because I don't want too much harsh stuff on my face. But I do use theirs because it gets both in one, and it's really soft and it's not harsh. What I'm using lately is the Marc Rubidoux Skin Care line, the Witch Hazel and Rose Water Toner. Not gonna lie, it seems like when you pour it on there, like nothing's on it. It seems literally like water, but it is really good. This is what I use. So I just take this. I've had this since like last summer. Yeah, right before school started. And I take another cotton round. I'm gonna pretty much drench it almost. But I'm just gonna put it all over my face. Some mornings, if I'm running late, I take the makeup remover that I showed you, and then I'll take the toner. Just put it on my face real quick, and then I'll tell them to do my whole routine. And put some moisturizer on and call it a day. Run out the door or do it in my car. After I put that on, I kind of fan it, let it soak in my skin, get in there a little bit more. And then, let's say, like, for instance, right now I do have them breaking out. I always catch my breakups. One of those. And all of them. I always catch my breakouts, like, right before they happen. So, like, the one that's, like, popping right here, popping up, I use this. This is the best ever. It's literally the drugstore, the Clean and Clear Advantage Acne Treatment Spa Treatment. It's the best thing ever. So I just take it and put it on the problem spot. Oh, I'm passing by. And this bad boy will be gone in like a day or two. The next step after your toner, and then after if you use like an acne spa treatment, the next thing I'm going to do is your serum. So I do use two serums right now. I always use the Versace Beauty Serum. That's the first serum I ever have used. But I started using the Milk Cosmetic one. So after, right after working my last skincare routine, so I started using the Milk Serum. And so the Milk one I use literally under my eyes because it's to help with like dark spots, like discoloration. So I use that one like right underneath my eyes first. And then I use the Versace Beauty Serum like all over my face. This is the Milk Cosmetic Serum. It's the, I don't know, I didn't have a name on it. I want to say it's like the watermelon one, and it's for brightening. If you say that, then what you're talking about. This is the one that I use. I take it and I just go like that. Go right there. Like in my discoloration spot. And from there, discoloration there too. Rub it in a little bit, and this is to help like with the dark circles that I get. This eye is actually a bruise. I had a allergic reaction last month, so that's why the eye is like way darker. You can see the blemish. And now we're gonna take the Versace Beauty Ultra Repairing Hydrating Serum. It replenishes, smooth, and softens for safe skin. Anytime it says for safe skin, I'm all for it. Like just know it. But this is here I use. Skincare or rose hip nourishing oil. I'll just use a little bit. Honestly, what I used to do is when I got a serums, I would always use the oil, but now that I have serums, I kind of still use a little bit of both just because it helps a little. This is what I use here, and then I fill it up like this, and then I just take it just a little bit, these little dots, just to help a little bit. Like, I don't know if it's like winter time, but I'm like losing my glow and it's not happening, you know what I mean? Like, chocolate has to shine, period. Take it. And this too, if you use too much of this oil, it's gonna last you a long time, but if you use too much of it, since your face is gonna feel so thick and greasy and you don't want that, so you use a little bit. So now that all that has set into my skin, this is how I'm looking so far. In case you're wondering, this is what my face looks like. My glow's coming back a little bit. Hey, how are you, sis? Okay, cool. Anyways, so the cream that I'm using, I have this cream now for over a year. Like, that's how much cream comes in here. It's Ultra Repair Cream, Intensive Hydration. Like, I've had it for so long, I can't even, like, read almost what it says anymore. But this is it. I literally, too much. I just do it for my face. I do like it. It's, like, not a thick cream. Until you use too much, you don't have this. So we are almost done with the skincare part, but then I'm showing my face now, and it looks like this is how it looks. To me, it glows. To me, it looks nice, especially if you get outside in some good lighting. It's like, and then I put on like my Milk Cosmetic the Kush mascara, and just my skin looking good. And some mascara, not even my brows, just mascara. And this, it's a look. We tried, effortless. Okay. So my last step, I don't know if it really works or not. Everyone goes crazy about it. I do it, I don't know if I see a difference, is a Marco Badescu skincare facial spray with aloe, herbs, and rose water. And this is what I use, but here we go. This always scares me. Now let it sit into the face, let it soak in. So while that does that, I'm gonna talk to you guys about some other things that I do. So when it comes to a face mask, the best face mask is the Indian clay mask. That is one of my legit, oh my god, the Aztec mask. Like, if I'm ever having problems with my fins, are you a fish? My skin is feeling funny and dry, or I'm having like breakouts or like problems. I put that mask on by the next day, like my skin's like stripped of whatever is the problem. Like, I love it to death. But if you want to go with something that you can use kind of more every day, that's more light. I also have the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Instant Oatmeal Mask. It's for 10 minutes. Helps nourish and rejuvenate your skin. I do like this one. It's a soft mask. It's not too much. It's a little gentle. So that helps out a lot. When it comes to a lip scrub, though, only one lip scrub in the world. Mint Juleps by Lush. If you don't have this, like, what are you doing? Clock just got moved forward, so you know how it was just 1:57. It's now 3:17. I just lost a whole hour. Moment of silence, please. Okay, I'm pretty much just almost done to my face. Honestly, at this point, I kind of like just go off. I wander off somewhere when my face gets like this. But yeah, so that's kind of something that I recommend. Always make sure you are cleansing and washing your face after workouts, after you sweat, after you come from school, makeup, you know, all of it. You don't want that built up on your face, and change your pillowcases, people. But yeah, so after I would do my skincare routine like this, then I would put on my lip, like some type of lip, Vaseline, whatever it is. I also have one by Lush. It's a nice lip scrub. If you're gonna use a lip scrub, use their lip balm right after, it's fire. So yeah, that is the end of my skincare routine. I hope you guys learned something. I hope you guys like my skin looks. But yeah, this is the end of my routine. Let me know if you have any questions. If you're trying the products, comment down below. Let me know which ones you try. If you have any questions, anything you want to know, like, let me know. I got you. And of course, I'll always update you on anything new that I try to help with the skin. But yeah, so this is overall my skin. This is how we're looking. This is how we come in. Okay. Yeah, be sure to subscribe down below. I always do weekly college vlogs in my life, so you get to just know all my tips and tricks. Anything that ever really happens in my life is in my vlog. So go there, follow me on social media. Got you. Alright, thanks you guys. Talk to you guys later. See you in the next video. Bye.